Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my wonderful brothers and sisters. Welcome to this quick reminder to do with this wonderful guest that we're going to hug with our body parts and with our heart. The guest that's so honorable, mentioned in the Holy Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. The month of Ramadan that Allah revealed the Holy Quran in it. Guidance for mankind. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let us realize that sinners are winners in Ramadan. What does that mean? Because there is an ongoing sinner's power repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's an ongoing wave of sinners, their roots of repentance, it is in Ramadan. And they graduate from the month of Ramadan as a big winners. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Repent to Allah, all of you believe, so you may achieve success. So success in this life, success in the grave, success in the hereafter. So truly, Ramadan is the month of repentance, شهر التوبة, the month of begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the month that you keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the favorite dua, even in the night of power. But this is actually dua should stay with us for the rest of our life. Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Oh Allah, you are forgiving, you love forgiveness. Oh Allah, grant us your forgiveness. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pinpointed a reality to show us what does it mean, Ramadan, by saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Oh, you believe, fasting is prescribed upon you, as it was prescribed upon those who were before you, so you may achieve piety. Take a look at this, the beginning of this verse and reality, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is honoring you, calling you believers. Yes, يَا رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. Fasting is prescribed upon you. So this prescription from the healer of all healers, when you take a regular prescription and you take it to the pharmacy and cash that and take the medication, even you can't read the medication, and you trust that prescription, trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed it, right, to our hearts. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you may achieve piety. Or you believe, fasting is prescribed upon you. So it's a prescription to heal our hearts. And everything in this dunya, it is a matter of a heart. Prescribed upon you, as it was prescribed upon those who were before you. Those who were before us, respected brothers and sisters, they did not have all the comfort and the leisure and the varieties of food and drinks, yet they did fast, yet they achieved taqwa. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah said, so you may achieve piety. Not so you may differ and fight today Ramadan, tomorrow Ramadan, today a person divorcing his wife because she's gonna fast tomorrow and he's not fasting. That's not the purpose of Ramadan, to keep arguing. And reality, it is not the difference in moon sighting. It is the difference in our hearts. Our hearts is not together. So therefore, wonderful brothers and sisters, realize that Ramadan, prescription to our hearts, to heal our hearts, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is helping us to make one step on the escalator to take us up to achieve taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means to make a change, a positive change in our hearts. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the situation of people unless they change what's within themselves. So therefore, you enter Ramadan and you graduate from Ramadan with a positive change in your heart that stays with you for the rest of your life. So therefore, sinners are winners in Ramadan when they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Speaking of that, I love to mention year after year, the situation of this young man, youth. He never fasted in his life. And this story I witnessed in Toronto, Canada. Ramadan just about to start, and he started discussing discussing this issue within himself that I'm going to fast. I can't handle Ramadan. Come and leave without me fasting. And right away, the fight within النفس الأمارة بالسوء, the nafs that command you to do evil, and the shaitan start battling him. You can't fast. You never fasted in your life. And he kept talking to himself, I can't handle it. I can't handle the thought that Ramadan to come and to leave without me fasting. And he kept battling the shaitan, and he's not paying attention. This, the nafs within and the shaitan arm wrestling him and battling him. No, you can't fast. You'll get tired. At the end, the shaitan took the best shot at him and said, you never fasted. You're going to be so exhausted and tired. Can't go to work. Then he said, and speaking to himself, I will fast. Even if I have to crawl in my stomach, I will fast. And he said, Ramadan started. I was so happy. I fasted for the first time in my life, even though he was a youth. And I was so thrilled, a delicious taste for this life of fasting. And then he said, I was crying. Why crying? He was crying, and actually I witnessed his tears. I witnessed that he's crying. Why? Because Ramadan is coming to end. He lived a beautiful life, delicious taste, and now it's coming to end. Allah helped his heart to let go of Ramadan and say, see you soon. But what happened? This is not the end of the story. After Ramadan, he started fasting one day and skipping one day for a few years. This is a person who never fasted in his life. Never point the finger at anyone, whether a brother or a sister, and criticize them and crucify them. Point 10 fingers up to Allah and pray for them, my dear brothers and sisters. This is a person who never fasted in his life. What happened to him? He kept fasting day in, day out. So he skipped a day, fast one day, skip a day for a few years. This is not the end of the story. He tells his own story. He says, wallahi, I was not paying attention when I was battling the shaitan. I was not paying attention that Allah is paying attention. Allah is listening to me. And Allah witnessed that battle, that I will go to work even if I have to crawl in my stomach, ashab ala batni, I will fast. He said, Allah help me. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you may achieve piety. So realize that Ramadan is not just for the good people. Ramadan is for the sinners as well, to become better than me and you, to become not just good people, excellent people. You will find certain practicing brothers or sisters and living the wonderful, beautiful life of Islam, the happy life of Islam. The roots of that happiness started in Ramadan. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let us realize that Ramadan, a month of repentance, a month of making a change, and a month to make an overhaul to our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make one step on the escalator to take you up to the better life. My dear brothers and sisters, Ramadan also the month of sadaqat. So what does that mean? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the best of Allah's creation, the best of Allah's creation sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to be so generous, and the highest generosity and the highest peak of his generosity, it was in Ramadan. So make sure you are a successful business lady or a businessman to always do business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and give fi sabilillah. No power can prove me wrong. All the verses in the Holy Quran that speak about charity will apply to you. All the promises in the prophetic statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will apply to you once you are kind and generous fi sabilillah. Also, some people, they would say, I will delay my sadaqat or my zakat till Ramadan to get the humongous reward and the 700 times fold. As a matter of fact, wonderful brothers and sisters, take a look at this. The ulama, they urge that if you are planning to give your sadaqat in Ramadan or zakat in Ramadan, but some catastrophe or a tragedy or an earthquake or dire need for the humanity or the Muslim ummah happens, you could still give it before Ramadan and get the reward of Ramadan. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees in your heart You want to give it in Ramadan, and you want to gain the blessing of Ramadan and the humongous reward of Ramadan, but there is an urgency and emergency now before Ramadan, and you give it now, you get the same blessings. Wonderful brothers and sisters, dear believers, let us also realize that fasting, it is not just holding your tongue and stomach from eating or drinking for several hours. You have to control the tongue from gossip. You have to control your tongue from ill talk. We have to use the tongue as a shovel to shovel thousands and thousands of hasanat, especially in the month of Ramadan, and to feed the needy and mend the hearts of certain brothers and sisters in our community or in the global community. So Ramadan to charge your iman. Ramadan to strengthen your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan to get rid of sins. Ramadan to make a new start. Ramadan to keep you going and growing, to survive and thrive in this life. So Ramadan, my dear brothers and sisters, it is above us right now. It is above us and it's coming. And that's the real happiness, that you see it coming. Because once it starts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ, counted days, يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ, يَا Allah, in these counted days, what do you want us to do? The answer comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pinpointed this reality by saying, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ, counted days, يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ, يَا Allah, يَا حَنَّان, يَا مَنَّان, what do you want us to do in these counted days? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fa, look at the tiny letter in Arabic, fa, التعقيب, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, means right away, race to do good deeds. Not just do good deeds, race to do good deeds. Wonderful brothers and sisters, we witnessed in this last 2 years of pandemic, started with epidemic, pandemic, and then may Allah forbid to become endemic, the COVID-19. We have so many loved ones that we lost. They would love to donate anything, to donate their house, to donate their children, to donate everything in this life, to have your opportunity to fast and to pray and to make tahajjud and to read the Quran and to do business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have the chance and choice today that preparing your heart for this honorable guest, the guest of Ramadan, it's a matter of a heart. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The place of taqwa and piety, it is in the heart. So you take that prescription from the healer of all healers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fasting, and you apply the fasting so you may achieve that pure heart. You may achieve taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this 1 minute left, my dear brothers and sisters, I tell you, never forget your brothers and sisters in the dua. Always make a dua for your brothers and sisters, even for strangers. The angel in charge will say ameen and you get the same. So be happy that soon you're going to hug the month of Ramadan. May Allah keep loving you, blessing you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you reach Ramadan healthier and wealthier with higher state of iman. Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allah khair. Stay blessed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.